Good morning, and welcome to the Co-Cathedral of St. John the Evangelist. Just a reminder before Mass begins to please silence your cell phones, pagers, any other electronic devices. At the ends of your pews, you will find a worship aid. You can pass these down. They have the music for today's Mass so that you can more fully participate. In that worship aid is our gathering song, Parce Domine. Please stand and join us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, in communion with the Holy Spirit, be with all of you. Amen. Celebrating Laetar Sunday to rejoice on the journey of Lent, the Church has given us this time celebration, rose vestment, kind of an awareness. We are on the road to Jerusalem, but we can rejoice in all of what will happen with passion, death, and resurrection. We're mindful of the embrace of God's love. Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you teach us the path of new life. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you lead us to the Father in the surprise of the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. And let us pray. O God, who through your word reconcile the human race to yourself in a wonderful way, grant, we pray, that with prompt devotion and eager faith, the Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebration to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. I invite children for the children's liturgy of the word. Thank you, Mary.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. In those days, all the princes of Judah, the priests and the people, added infidelity to infidelity, practicing all the abominations of the nations and polluting the Lord's temple, which he had consecrated in Jerusalem. Early and often did the Lord, the God of their fathers, send his messengers to them, for he had compassion for his people and his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of God, despised his warnings, and scoffed at his prophets, until the anger of the Lord against his people was so inflamed that there was no remedy. Their enemies burnt the house of God, tore down the walls of Jerusalem, set all its palaces afire, and destroyed all its precious objects. Those who had escaped the sword were carried captive to Babylon, where they became servants of the king of the Chaldeans and his sons, until the kingdom of the Persians came to power. All this was to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah. Until the land has retrieved its lost Sabbaths, during all the time it lies waste, it shall have rest while 70 years are fulfilled. In the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah, the Lord inspired King Cyrus of Persia to issue this proclamation throughout his kingdom, both by word of mouth and in writing. Thus says Cyrus, king of Persia, all the kingdoms of the earth, the Lord, the God of heaven, has given to me, and he has also charged me to build him a house in Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Whoever therefore among you belongs to any part of his people, let him go up, and may his God be with him. The word of the Lord.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat and wept, remembering Zion. On the poplars that grew there, we hung up our harps. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget. For it was there that they asked us our captors for songs, our oppressors for joy. Sing to us, they said, one of Zion's songs. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you? Oh, how could we sing the song of the Lord on alien soil? If I forget you, Jerusalem, let my right hand wither. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Oh, let my tongue cleave to my mouth if I remember you not. If I prize not Jerusalem above all my joys, let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, God, who is rich in mercy, because of the great love he had for us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, brought us to life with Christ. By grace you have been saved. Raised us up with him and seated us with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace and his kindness to us in Jesus Christ. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you. It is the gift of God. It is not from works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for the good works that God has prepared in advance, that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to Nicodemus, "Just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the verdict, excuse me, that the light came into the world, but people preferred darkness to light because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come toward the light, so that his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God. The Gospel of the Lord. So we're looking a little light, which means that even though the clocks are automatic, it still doesn't work. So hopefully 11:15 will be flowing over. Hopefully. So how do I earn God's love? Now hopefully you're immediately saying, but I don't need to earn God's love. But often I hear that from folks. We get in a certain place and we just feel like, I need to earn it, I need to make it happen. But Paul is reminding us, as Bridget just read, for by grace you've been saved through faith. And this is not from you, it is the gift of God. So God's love is gratuitous. It's given with no strings attached. Really given. So I don't earn. But the deeper question that I want us to reflect on together is, how will God's love reach me? Reach us? Reach you? There's no question that God's love is given, profoundly available, if you will. And yet, we can be starved. We can lean into the darkness in contrast to the light. How will God's love reach us? How does it happen? We can look at Moses, first of all, because Jesus starts out with this awareness on the part of Moses. Here he is with the people, and there are the plagues, and so there is this tremendous confusion and pain about these poisonous snakes biting them. And so Moses, with the voice of God, God tells him to create a serpent, a snake, and lift it up. And when you look at the serpent, the one who bit you, you will be healed. You will be set free. Take a look at the worship aid for a moment, the front. Because there we have it. We have the cross, because ultimately, in this little piece of art, Moses lift up the serpent, the snake. They have been bitten, and they will be healed. Jesus, like Moses, will be lifted up on the cross for us. When we think of the cross, and we happen, this is a beautiful image of Christ, but it's more of a resurrection cross, if you will, because Jesus has his head up, to the Father. It's not the Good Friday cross that we know, but think of the Good Friday cross. So what do we see? Violence, betrayal, suffering, pain, death. And ultimately, we hear Jesus say, Father, why have you abandoned me? Here's the humanity. God, Jesus, fully human and fully divine. And there is the concert tension. But in his humanity, he cries out, why have you abandoned me? So what we see in the cross and what we recognize is that when we have our own pain, our own suffering, our own fear, we need to go to the cross with whatever bit you. We have been bitten with trauma, with all kinds of trials of life. Name them in your own heart for a moment. How have you been bitten with trauma, with pain, with suffering, with betrayal? What about your fear? My fear. That I can go to the cross, which is lifted up, and discover healing. The truth of love. I've been very mindful of the Pocatino family for our guests. Alberto is a cardiovascular surgeon here at Mayo, and Rebecca leads a Bible study here, and they're very active. He's a lecturer. And they got a call a week ago Tuesday that their son Marcus, 38 years old, father of two children, and his wife was killed in a car accident. It's the call that no parent ever wants to receive. So think of the pain. Think of the drama. And where and how will they discover healing? The funeral was Friday. It's the beginning. And then all those steps of grief because they have been bitten. That's a dramatic experience, but what is yours? What is mine? Where are we set free so that we can say, how will God's love reach me? I need to look at the cross like Moses with the serpent. They were bitten by a snake, and they are set free in looking at what bit them. To look at the cross with my pain, or to acknowledge my fear, to have a glass of wine with my fear, my trauma, to become more friendly, to have a coffee with my fear. Because our inclination is to run away, to hide, or to get revenge. And then we don't have any experience. Christ, God's love, in truth, cannot reach us. I'm running away. I have good reason to run away. And ultimately, in the circle and cycle of life, I need to face and to look at it. For God so loved the world, we heard in the gospel, that he gave his only son. Now that's beautiful, and it's only abstract unless I can open myself to receive. God so loved the world that he gave his only son. You might be saying, I conclude, yeah, but you don't understand. My pain, my suffering, my fear, my trauma is so big, is so devastating that I can't do what Jesus proposes. It's not true. God so loved the world that he gave his only son in love, and I must come with my trauma, with my circumstances, and trust that Christ will accompany me. And I have to come with the ways I have been bitten by the snake of darkness. This will be the last time. Take your worship aid again. I won't do this to you again. And go to page 5. Our friends will sing this after communion during time. Isn't it amazing? This is composed and written in 1591. Let's read this together in the bottom of page 5. Oh, heart of my Lord, gravely wounded, sharp knife, but by the massacre caused by love. Oh, soft heart, when I see you again, you were put into so much agony. I feel my soul failing, neither voice nor sight have heard. O soft love, enter my heart. I am available. I desire that you come and embrace my fear, the ways I've been bitten, and I can't run away from it. I need to go right towards it. I cannot hide for healing. During Lent, we are praying the Apostles' Creed. Let us stand, and it's in the worship aid if you're more comfortable. I believe the Father Almighty, in the name of Jesus, we come with all those silent prayers, the people we especially want to remember, and we are so mindful of the entire world.
For the church, especially for Pope Francis on the upcoming anniversary of his election, that the Lord will sustain him in his ministry and help him lead us from darkness to the freedom of the children of God. Let us pray to the Lord. for all who are serving in the military in dangerous areas, that God will protect them and those they serve. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who bear the cross of illness, may they experience the comforting touch of God. Let us pray to the Lord. For those called to die and rise again with Christ through the sacrament of baptism, in particular, Paisley, who is celebrating new life through the waters of baptism this weekend. Let us pray to the Lord. That those who have died may be raised up with Christ and seated in the glory of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
We just pause for a moment. If you think of Gaza and all of children, malnutrition, Israel, Ukraine, the drama of the world. God of love, we believe that you sent your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, in love. There is so much darkness, but help us to stay with the light of Christ. And in our own story, our own journey, to be honest about our fear, about our trauma, and come to you, Christ, trusting that you will accompany us to new life through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. We place before you with joy these offerings, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting for the salvation of all the world through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ. By the mystery of the Incarnation, he has led the human race that walked in darkness into the radiance of the faith, and has brought those born in slavery to ancient sin through the waters of regeneration, to make them your adopted sons and daughters. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Son and your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, John the Evangelist with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Josephine, Paquita, Ricardo, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family that has gathered this morning. You have summoned them before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
We invite your generosity this morning, and our second collection is for Catholic relief services. You often see on the news, I mean, there's so many dramatic places of need around the world, but Catholic Relief Services arrives, and that's because of you and all the people of the world who contribute. Thank you. And we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
for the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the world.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share God's love and peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
please join in singing our communion song found on page 5 of your worship aid, "We Are the Light of the World."
Save it as a soul.
Thank you for your generosity for Catholic relief services reaching around the world to the cry of so many people. Let us pray. O God, who enlighten everyone who comes into this world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you in all sincerity, through Christ our Lord. And bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Look upon those who call to you, O Lord, and sustain the weak. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death. And bring those rescued by your mercy and love from every evil to reach the highest good through Christ our Lord. Just a reminder, we have a 12:10 Mass here in the church, Monday through Friday, to which you're most welcome. We have Stations of the Cross on Friday at 5:15, and there are so many other opportunities, the art series on Thursday evenings, and, you know, just pay attention, bulletin, webpage. It's a beautiful walk, but we need to kind of take some serious decisions and steps with our time. We are having, and I know it's a ways away, an anointing mass on April 3rd, so Wednesday at 10 a.m. So it's a beautiful gift, the sacrament of anointing. So you're free to come. I'm just aches and pains, or maybe someone who's trying to become pregnant, another person maybe with mental illness, struggling. It's a wide range, and it's a beautiful sacrament. We already gave our generosity to the Catholic Relief Services, but also we have the rice bowls. They're out in the gathering space available. 75% of the rice bowl monies go for around the world, and 25% stays here in our diocese. So the tradition of the rice bowl and putting change is a beautiful thing to teach children. The Catholic Ministry's appeal, thank you most sincerely to those who have major commitment, and Bishop Barron is waiting for the rest of you. So there's envelopes available out in the gathering space if somehow you misplaced it or think you didn't receive it. We invite also to remember and honor loved ones. There are envelopes there in the little pocket in the pew. So we have 50 days of Easter, and you always come through in a wonderful way for the environment. So you can remember a loved one or a marriage anniversary or just all kinds of ways. You make a donation, put that on that envelope, and we will publish that in the bulletin, the ones you desire to remember on May 12th, which is the Ascension. Thank you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. May you have a lovely day, and let us go in peace.
Please join us in our song of sending, found on page 6 of your worship aid, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light.
As a child of the light, I want to follow Jesus.